Hey guys, come and check out this massive 600 amp hour full off-grid system we've done in this Jayco Optimum Motorhome. Hey guys, so now we're in the center of the caravan where all the magic happens, and I'll run through exactly what we've done, why we've done it, and what it can do for you. This is where everything is. So this is, we've got two 300 amp hour lithium batteries jammed in here, the Enerdrive Btecs. We've got the 2600 watt inverter, the MPPT solar controller, and the Enerdrive DC-DC. They're all crammed under the floor. They're not taking up couch space. They're not taking up bed space. They're actually in under the floor in this motorhome, which makes this system so great. So to start off with, for an off-grid setup, obviously most important part of the whole system is your battery storage. Now with this motorhome, we have gone with two 300 amp hour Enerdrive Btec lithium batteries. A few questions we get asked all the time is, why Enerdrive? Why do we use Enerdrive components? Reason for that is really quite simple. They're super reliable, super well made, pretty good price point too. And their after sales backup in Australia is impeccable. There are a few other brands obviously now doing similar equipment to do similar setups, but you'll never find another company that has the after sales backup Australia wide that Enerdrive does. They really stand behind their product. And that means if you ever do have an issue, you're in the middle of nowhere, you know you're gonna be helped. So the 300 amp hour lithium batteries, there's two in under here. They are massive. But they are absolutely fantastic. So this gives a customer 600 amp hours of total lithium battery storage, which means that they can run appliances for quite a long time. Out the aircon for sort of 6 to 7 hours, even more depending on conditions. Hundreds of uses of kettles, toasters, that sort of thing. The batteries themselves, they have a 5-year warranty on them. They have a built-in Bluetooth monitor. Now, in an off-grid setup like this, we actually use a separate battery monitor, which I'll show you in a second, the Enerdrive ePro, to monitor as one bank. But you can actually log into each battery individually on your mobile phone and see exactly each one's health, its charge, how quick they're charging, discharging. So you can really monitor exactly what's going on with each battery to make sure everything is tip-top. So obviously that's the batteries we have in under here. The rest of it is obviously the inverter and the charging gear. So in under here, we have the Enerdrive DC to DC charger. Now the whole idea of this charger, it is to obviously charge these battery banks while this motorhome's in motion. Some people say, oh, you don't need a DC-DC, you might just need a voltage sensitive relay. Unfortunately, that's not correct, especially with lithium batteries. They do require a proper charge from the DC-DC charger to charge them to 100% and to charge them properly, essentially, and to prolong the life of the batteries as well. A lot of new cars have smart alternators, which means that essentially they don't produce a high enough voltage to charge any batteries, be lithium or not, once their own battery is full. So this overcomes any of those issues, provides a fail-safe, reliable charge to these batteries all the time while you're driving a full 40 amps. So you know you're always gonna be topped up when you arrive to your destination. Other charge we have in under here is the Enerdrive MPPT solar controller. This is the 40 amp version. These are a really, really good charger for the price point. They are only retail for $350, so they are extremely well priced, and they are MPPT, which means they are the most efficient type of solar controller on the market at the moment. So what the solar controller actually does in this off-grid setup is it takes the higher voltage that the solar panel supply, the unregulated supply, comes down into this device. This device then takes that, you know, 18, 20 volts or whatever your panel voltage may be, puts it into a suitable voltage and a suitable charge format for the batteries and charges them as you need them. The reason why we go a separate solar controller as well as the DC-DC chargers, the DC-DCs have built-in solar as well, is so that you get simultaneous charge from the car and from the solar. So what that means is you're getting 40 amps from the DC-DC as well at the same time, you're potentially getting another 40 amps from the solar controller, obviously depending on sunshine, which means that you can be getting up to an 80 amp charge while you're driving, which is insane. Really, really good amount of charge there. The other component, which is the obviously major component in the system is an inverter. So for those of you who don't know, or you're starting out on your journey for off-grid setups, you're not sure what the components do, the inverter essentially changes your 12 volt power from your battery bank into your 240 volt power, which is the same type of power you'd have at home. So traditionally, pretty much all caravans that come out standard new, unless they're spec'd with them, they won't have an inverter, which means that any of your 240 volt appliances that you have, so kettles, toasters, induction cookers, hair dryers, won't work off grid. So this is what makes it possible to have all those appliances, all your creature comforts you'd have at home, work in an off grid application. With the use of this, which is the Enerdrive 2600 watt inverter, it now allows us to do all that. So, and even the aircon too. So the factory air conditioner now works fully off grid in the middle of nowhere. You can now have your hair dryers, your kettles, toasters, all those appliances work without any issues whatsoever in a fully off grid.
Yep.
One great feature about these Enerdrive inverters that not many other inverters have on the market is they have a built-in AC transfer switch. Now you might be wondering, what the hell does that mean? What that means is it integrates into your existing 240 volt system almost seamlessly, which means that if you have the inverter switched on, just a little button on the wall, and you plug into grid, plug into your house, your shore power, mains power, whatever you want to call it, it means it's going to automatically switch over and use that for the supply. And the moment that's unplugged, the moment that's disrupted, it means that it's going to swap instantaneously straight over to the battery power to supply a van with that 240 volts. So if you're running things like a computer or something without a battery backup, this actually acts as the battery backup, which means obviously no dropouts and obviously increased reliability. And yeah, it's fantastic. You might be wondering, in under here, I haven't shown you where the 240 volt charger is. So in this Jayco motorhome, the 240 volt charger is actually part of the original battery management system, which we've disabled most of, but we've kept the 240 volt charging side of it, which is located in a box outside. I'll show you in a second. So as I explained before, this Jayco, like many Jaycos, has a J35 charging system. This one came out originally with a J35C, which is not lithium compatible, so we've swapped it out for the J35D. Now, all this unit does now is purely just the 240 volt charging side of it, as well as that water tank monitoring and everything I mentioned before. But so this is just doing the 240 volt charge from your shore power now. So up here is where all the monitoring and switching and everything happens that controls everything under there. So the whole idea is obviously you don't have to lift the floor up. You shouldn't have to touch anything under there in any normal circumstances. Everything you need to do, need to switch, need to control is done up here as it was sort of designed in the factory. We've just added a couple bits. So in a lot of Jaycos, they have what they call the Jhub tablet. Some other caravans that use BMPro equipment might have the Odyssey tablet. It's all much the same thing, does the same sort of functions. What we've done here and is to put in a separate Enerdrive ePro monitor. Now, there are pros and cons to both ways of doing this. It's entirely up to the customer how they want to play this. So for this setup, so we've gone for the Enerdrive ePro for a couple of reasons. So the first reason is mainly reliability. So the ePro gauges are extremely reliable, extremely dependable. I don't think I've had a single one fail ever. And they maintain accuracy with no dropouts. They're a hardwired unit. There's actually a data cable that runs from there through into the battery system. So that means there's no Bluetooth dropouts. And yeah, there's no reliability issues there. You always have an extremely accurate and easy to read idea of what your battery system's doing. The other way to do it, I've explained before, is to integrate it into this via the use of that shunt. A lot of people prefer this method purely just because it keeps everything in one central screen. So your battery monitoring stays through here rather than having that separate monitor. The downside to doing it this way is that it is a Bluetooth connection. So while it is mainly reliable, you are relying on a wireless connection, which obviously can have interference in certain areas or certain conditions where it may drop out and have to be reset or something like that. So if you're one who likes aesthetics, and wants everything to look pretty and super neat and tidy, you'd go for the integration. Or if you're someone who would rather have something super simple, easy to read, and more reliable, you'd go for the Enerdrive ePro gauge like we've done here. Entirely up to you. So in terms of controlling what we've put in here, like I mentioned before, the Jhub tablet does all the switching. So it switches your lights, your water pumps, puts the slide out in and out, that sort of jazz. In terms of battery monitoring now, it's all done up through here. So this Enerdrive ePro gauge is super, super simple to read and operate. It's standard rest screen like it is here, just gives you a really basic percentage. So obviously, you know, 0 to 100% of how much charge is in your battery system, a visual representation around the outside, which obviously gives you the same thing, how full, how empty the system is. And then you can cycle through the settings. Standard, it comes up showing the amps either coming in or out of the system. So for instance, if you, let's say we have 40 amps coming in from our solar system, but we have an appliance using 20 amps of that, it will be showing a positive 20 amp charge going into the battery system. Cool. In terms of switching the inverter on and off, like I was talking about before. So what I was saying before about the transfer switch inside this inverter means that there's no big clunky changeover between mains power and off-grid off the battery system. The only thing you do have to touch is just this little button up here, which turns the inverter on. Once it's on, you can plug in, disconnect, whatever you want. It's not going to matter. It'll automatically swap between the sources. And yeah, and that's all you need to do. It's as simple as a couple second press of one button and you've got 240 volt off grid in the middle of Australia, run your aircon and all the bits you want to run. As always guys, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, comments, queries, leave them in the comment section down below. If you want to see any of our other off-grid setups we've done, check them out up here. And YouTube reckons you should watch this.